will give you sneaky ads that you could pick up on the waiver wire to help you win next week. And watch this video until the end to see us reveal our bid suggestion amounts for each player. Heading into week three, well, who's the running back that you think could be a little bit of a sneaky ad, or is it more of a captain obvious?
It's second chair obvious here. I think, you know, Tony Pollard will be the number one pickup for everybody, but Cordarrelle Patterson on the Falcons is the guy I want to talk about here. First of all, he may not qualify at running back in your league. Check your league settings to make sure. He may be wide receiver. He's always been a jack of all trades. Even Sunday against the Bucks, you know, 7 carries, 5 catches. You know, you're talking about a guy that does everything, returns kicks, scored twice, though. You know, we were talking earlier, oh, Mike Davis, we got to be, you know, we'll draft him. Even though he's a mediocre skills guy, there's no one else behind him. They cut Quadre Olison. How could they cut Quadre Olison when you got Cordarrelle Patterson? Patterson's a good pickup, this guy, especially if you're in a league where it's deeper rosters, 14 teams, 16 teams, you can use him.
We need a wide receiver who could be a little bit under the radar, somebody who may not be a big name. Do you have anybody for us heading into week three?
KJ Osborne has 15 targets the first 2 weeks for the Minnesota Vikings. Caught that big touchdown to start the game against Arizona on Sunday against the Cardinals. So you look at that and you look at the number of targets. Someone's got to be the number three there. We always thought, okay, maybe it's Chris Herndon. Maybe it's Ty Conklin. Maybe it's D.D. Westbrook. No, it's KJ Osborne, who had 0 targets last year. He was the other receiver drafted. He was drafted mostly as a kick returner. He's won the third receiver job for the Vikings. He's good. He's really good. We'll see what happens when teams pay attention to him a little bit more. But it's hard to argue with the 15 targets so far.
8 of the 12 teams in your league need a tight end. Do you have anybody for us heading into week three?
We're going to run the 12 formation this week. We're going to get you 2 tight ends. First guy I'm going to go with here is Harrison Bryant. You know, a guy that was drafted in the 4th round in 2020. Some hype about him in the draft, talking about how he has some upside. He went to a smaller school, Florida Atlantic, so not everybody knew about him, never knew about the competition level. With Jarvis Landry unlikely to play, OBJ uncertain this week, they may run 2-3 tight ends at a time out there. That the tight ends got most of the targets for the Browns against the Texans last week. It could be the same this upcoming week for Cleveland. They go up against Chicago. I think that this is a team that they can probably you're going to have to try to be a little bit creative with. They can't just run it down their throat like they did at the Texans. So I think you'll see Bryant, who's probably the most athletic of the 3 tight ends in terms of just running routes. I think he'll be a guy that will be a little bit active. Everyone will be over Austin Hooper and David Njoku, and for good reason, but Bryant's available. He's the guy you can go ahead and pick up right now.
If I get beat to the punch on Harrison Bryant, give me one more tight end that I could pick up.
Pat Freiermuth, the rookie out of Penn State. I like him with the Steelers. He got more targets than Eric Ebron this past week. You know, Deontay Johnson looks like he's escaped serious injury. They're talking that he'll probably be able to go. But what if he's compromised a little bit there? Go with Freiermuth against the Bengals this week. You might be surprised in what you can get at him. Everybody loves him in Dynasty Leagues. A lot of buzz about Freiermuth in Dynasty Leagues. He's finding, you know, he had that 2-touchdown preseason game. Someone that you can pick up and use.
In Superflex Leagues, which are becoming more and more of the mainstream, there's never a quarterback on the waiver wire. Could there be somebody to pick up this week if I'm in a real pinch?
So last week we talked about Taylor Heinicke and, you know, how you should go after him in a Superflex League because A, Fitzpatrick is out for the season, and B, we've seen Heinicke, know he can be good, and three, or C, I forget if I was going, what good construction I was going there, AB3, Washington has an offense that's somewhat interesting, and it proved to be that case on Thursday night. We don't have that this week. We have 3 guys that got hurt. We have Davis Mills stepping in for Tyrod Taylor in Houston. We have Jacoby Brissett stepping in for Tua in Miami. Those were both pretty ugly. We also have Jacob Eason stepping at the end of the game for Carson Wentz. The reason why I want to focus on Eason is Wentz has injuries to both of his ankles. I think he's the least likely of the three to play sitting here on a Monday morning. You know, maybe later in the week we'll have a little bit more definition. Eason had some success in the preseason, not a whole lot. It didn't look great against the Rams, but it was against the Rams. They're good. They're tough to throw against. Jalen Ramsey, you don't throw against him, as we learned. However, he faces the Titans this week. You can throw against the Titans. We've seen 2 weeks in a row where teams have thrown well against the Titans. This is actually a big game for the Colts and the Titans both. Colts are desperate. They need this. They need Easton to step up.
All right, Jeff, get ready to turn over your bid card for all the players that you talked about today on the count of 3. 1, 2, 3.